Welcome to a practice SAT math question. If a line is perpendicular to the line y equals 3x minus 4 and passes through the point 0,6, what is the equation of the perpendicular line? The first thing we should recognize is that the given linear equation is in slope-intercept form, or the form y equals mx plus b. When we have a linear equation in this form, m is the slope of the line, and b is the y-intercept. So if we're given the linear equation y equals 3x minus 4, we should recognize that the given line has a slope of positive 3, which we can also write as 3 over 1. The reason we want the slope in fraction form is that if two lines are perpendicular, their slopes are negative reciprocals of one another, which means if the slope of this line is 3 over 1, then if a line is perpendicular to this line, the slope would be negative 1 over 3. To find the negative reciprocal, we flip the fraction over and change the sign. So the slope of the perpendicular line is m equals negative 1 third. It's also true if we find the product of the slopes of perpendicular lines, the product is always negative 1. So from here we have half the information that we need. We now know that the equation of the perpendicular line would be y equals, because m is negative 1 third, we'd have negative 1 third x plus b, again where b is the y-intercept. But we're also told that the line passes through the point 0,6. And here's where we're kind of lucky, because the point 0,6 is on the y-axis and therefore is the y-intercept of the perpendicular line. So since we're given the point 0,6 where this is the y-intercept, we know b must equal positive 6. And therefore the equation of the line that's perpendicular to the given line and passes through the point 0,6 would be y equals negative 1 third x plus 6. So looking at our choices, our answer is C. Now I do want to point out that we were fortunate here that the given point was the y-intercept of the perpendicular line. If this point was not the y-intercept, but it was on the perpendicular line, we'd actually have to use these coordinates and perform substitution into this equation here to find B. So we'd substitute the y-coordinate here, the x-coordinate here, in order to find the value of b, or the y-intercept, if this point was not the y-intercept. Now before we go, let's actually verify that the given linear equation and the equation that we found would produce perpendicular lines. The graph of the given linear equation would produce the blue line, where notice how the y-intercept is negative 4, and the slope is 3, or 3 over 1. Notice if we pick this point on the blue line, and we go up 3 and right 1, we do find another point on the line. And the equation that we found for the perpendicular line was y equals negative 1 third x plus 6. Notice how the y-intercept is positive 6. And using the slope of negative 1 third, if we go down 1 unit and right 3 units, we do find another point on the red line, but more importantly, notice how when these two lines intersect, they do intersect and form a right angle, and therefore these two lines are perpendicular. I hope you found this helpful.